Experience of Ballyfermot was, I was only a young fella and my dad took me up the fields along the canal and we went across this wooden bridge which was known as the Dancing Bridge. It had wooden struts and there was a steel frame. But it was not, apparently, I'm assuming they danced there at some stage. But just down from that to the right hand side, it would probably be around the top of Cremona Road, there was a big barn. And they were going to pull down the barn because they were going to build houses on it. And the lads were up there getting pigeons, stray pigeons that had been racing and had strayed off and stayed there. And these lads out of the railway were going to get these pigeons. We don't know whether they ever got them or not, but that's my first experience of having farming, going across the barn. And the ramparts are still there. If you're going by the train between Coilmore Road and Leafanoo Road, the ramparts are still there for the old dancing place. They didn't take them away.
Yeah, yeah. And yourself, Pat, your Decies, or sorry.
Originally from Kempton Station.
Yeah.
And my most famous neighbour was the Dean of St. Patrick's. So, naturally we were in Tenement House and etc. And then when we moved to Ballyfermot, it was amazing that we had a child inside the house and a bath. And the electric plug on the wall. So I still went to school in Francis Station. You have to get the bus every day. And in the winter time, and the frost be on the ground, the buses weren't quite capable of getting there in and out. But every so often there was a special bus came up to Gary On Road, came out from Cunningham Road, and it was a banger of a bus. And a more times it broke down somewhere in Inchicore. You'd be out pushing the bus down the road. But when I moved on then, started up the work, we dear sir, blah blah blah, and your address was Decies Road, Inchicore. You couldn't go Ballyfermot town, you wouldn't get a look in, you know. So we were in the Inchicore and posh end, Ballyfermot.
Funny you mentioned something there, because the more people I speak to, he said, Sarsfield Road began, as you know, down the ranch and worked its way up. But people were putting down up the top of Ballyfermot, Sarsfield Road, Dublin 10. They never put Ballyfermot down because of the bad name, because you wouldn't get work. Much the same as what you're saying now, Alan.
Well, the thing about it was Ballyfermot wasn't a bad place. It was just a name. And like at 1953, of course, they were calling it Little Korea because the Korean War was on. And we moved up, like the bus only came to the bottom of Lambton Road, and it was like the country bus, the ranch was on there, and we used to ask for down there. And it's the only roundabout that I know that the bus goes up the wrong way now. I think it still does.
I'm not going to be
79.
79, I don't know where that goes from now.
Coilmore, it used to be Coilmore, but I don't know where it goes now.
No, it came into Lambton. But the roundabout, it just
went down the right hand side.
It was a landing road.
It didn't go round. It broke the log, you know what I mean?
It went up landing road.
But they couldn't fit around.
They're still going that way. They're still going
that way. That's what it meant. The other roundabout.
Yeah, they're still doing that.
They haven't altered. The other variation that Inchicore business was, for some reason or other, the electoral wards in Ballyfermot, from 166 Leafanoo Road down, I think 92 was the last house on Leafanoo Road, down the bottom of Cold Parks. They are in the Chapel Isard electrical ward, and people found this out, and all of a sudden now, they start putting Chapel Isard on it. People are all Chapel Isard, up to 166. Yeah. It broke actually at the end of one block of house, and 168 started.
They were in the Chapel Isard.
Yeah, but anyone who lived from 92 to 1 used to try and put Chapel Isard on their letters.
Well, the bus it used to end at the bottom of London, and then eventually the houses were being built, it came up to a whole road, which had reversed itself around and came back down again. But in the winter time, you know, in the dark then, Ennis's had asses and horses and all sorts of things. So one of the asses decided to die on the road. And of course the bus came up, very bad lights on it, straight up the top of the blinking ass. That's the truth. So everything came to a standstill, no buses were coming. And next one was a veteran who was shot by
ass.
The ass in the head.
Yeah.
And then the bus had to be lifted up to get the ass out. That was the end of Ennis's ass. Sorry, Ennis's house.
I'm sure if you see this, you'll get a good laugh out of that now. You know, that's his family. Yeah.
Ennis is my great neighbours.
Yeah.
Even though like, they had chickens in the back, the horse in the back, you know, like, everything. Yeah. They always looked after.
It was a rural house.
Yes,
they were great neighbours. Yeah.
But you went to Brunswick Street then, you were saying? Was
no, Francis.
Or Francis Street, I think.
Francis
Street.
Yeah, the Christian Brothers.
That's because the school wasn't open here.
No school.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And then we ran the little the tempers. So in them days, you had an hour and a half to a dinner, half 12 to 2 o'clock. So I was able to go from Francis Street to the tempers to get me dinner and go back again.
I see, yeah.
Like people, some people were from Brindley and used to get the bus. Oh, the dripping from Patrick Street up back in.
The Cairns went to Whitefire Street.
Yeah, and Baggot Street.
Baggot Street. The boys went to Baggot Street. The Cairns, they separated them. It was a coal on there.
There was a bus from Climo Road.
School. Yeah. And what school did you go to yourself?
The Albert's.
Oh, you went to the Albert's.
Yeah.
And was this your first posting then? And you got to. As a postman, did you come?
No, I was a telegraph messenger for 4 years, and I mixed with the stars. I was a telegraph messenger and radio wave. That was because I was so quiet. I mixed with all the stars then and radio. There was no television. And then I went out, became a postman, and the first road I delivered was the North Sector Road. It was that side of the Liffey part was done by James Street. Now afterwards, they used the Liffey as a different numbers, you know, the James Street became Dublin 8, like the far side of the Liffey was Dublin 7. But I delivered an North Circle around in Deadly Gardens, and then I hit me peak when I was postman to the president in the park, the Papal Nunciature and the American Embassy and all. But I loved to live, cycling around the park was really scenic in those days, with very few cars around.
And then you came to Ballyer.
Then I came to Ballyer. What a shift. Wow.
Hey, there's another thing too. Raptor's house.
That's right, yeah.
The parish. That was the parish police house at the time. But then he got another house that. But that Raptor's house, like, when I was in Kevin Street as a child, the cows used to come in for the winter. And Raptors had a dairy at the bottom of New Street, but also in facing the Dean of St. Patrick's was Callow's Lane, which is Callow Gilmore, the Forge.
Oh, yeah.
And at the top of that lane, there was the cows were all housed for the winter. They were, I suppose, they were merch now, you know, like they were from the markets to the.
That's right.
But they came in from Ballyfermot, and Raptors had places in town.
Just as some people say, that's because the ranch got its name back then, because the mall coming from the west with the cows into the market, used to go by and some kind of songs, and this is like a ranch back in.
Well, there was a ranch up in Glendalton as well.
Is there?
Yeah, just up past, you know, where the ibis of the ibis of the head. Yeah. It was just there on the right hand side past the roundabout. If you're going up the nice road, just past the Red Cow roundabout, on the right hand side, about 200 yards up, is another ranch. That was another ranch for some reason or another.
Yeah, but no one could actually say specifically why it got its name. You know, it's something similar like the California Hills. No one would say how it got its name, but just.
Yeah.
Do you reckon it's because of the cattle coming in? I don't know, you know. But then, yourself, Cecil, how I remember you coming up the road. What roads did you cover?
Well, originally my delivery was Ballyfermot Road from. I delivered the Deed of Sal to the brothers in Deed of Sal, and then started 73 Ballyfermot, which is the corner of Gary Owen. And I'd done that and the Coyle Morris. And then up Leafin Hill Road and up to Gallingstown before there was the house was built. But there was a wall of works up there, and Sylvester Murray, his brother was a well known boxer or something, Russians Murray or something they called him. But there was a farmhouse that was up, and it was on the far side of the railway. But it was a no man's land. It was really, I remember I got tested by an inspector one time to see how long it would take me, and he swore he stood on his bike and could see the curragh.
But what I remember about yourself was coming up the road, Ballyfermot Drive, and I think anyone within those areas that you're talking about.
That's where you ended up on.
Kids of my vintage. You knew everyone.
Yeah.
You knew everyone by name.
Number. Give me a number, I give you a name. That was
And you were always in a great mood. I don't know how you did. That's my memory now as a young fellow growing up.
Well, I've always considered myself very lucky in life. I have very, very good health and different things. But one of the greatest starts kind of you could get was this chap Paddy Donnelly, who ran Bromley. He lived on a Moor Road.
It's actually behind you now.
And the story is again, like I was saying about Ballyfermot. If he called it Ballyfermot, you know, or something like that. So he looked for a posh name that sounded like Ballyfermot. That's why he's allegedly called it Bromley. But Paddy was one of the greatest characters that I have ever met. I worked with him, I think, for about 35 years. And you'd go into James Street Morning and be lashing rain, and you knew you had to cycle to Ballyfermot or Bow Lane and that, and you're going to be drowning. And you go in there and he'd start some fuss or crack going there. And you cycle out a lot, wasn't it? The sun could be shining, you were laughing all the way up there. And there was great camaraderie there between the lovers at that stage, you know. And it just, it's no good crying. I loved life, I loved people. When we're around with people, I loved them, you know.
Yeah. But so much so that when you played with Bromley, as you can see there, you played with Bromley. But best of all, it was this one that I came across, this photograph of your retirement on Ballyfermot Drive.
Yeah.
And again, I think it's up there somewhere. But you have all the locals there, and I know they all love you. I'm sure many of those people have been looking at them now, my own mother's in the dead and gone, but I know their families knew you so well. You know, and I know they loved you so much so that they called you back to the road for a bit of a party at a retirement deal.
But the big thing too was that the traders organised a night for me over in the Sheraton Hotel there on the Coilmore Road. And Bertie Ahern was Taoiseach at the time, and he was supposed to come and present me with this trophy, very kind of him. And it turns out he was on peace negotiations with Gerry Adams at the time. So unfortunately, kind of, as we were coming home, he was coming in, so I never got the presentation, but they were very good to me, everyone, the traders, and especially the people. I mean, there was, as I say, there wasn't a morning you went down there, you had a bit of crack with one or two of them.
I know, yeah.
And nobody had a button, but my God, they had a sense of humour and all
that. Yeah, that comes out more people to talk. No, we all have the same, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And what about yourself, Dad? You went to work with Fiat, did you?
Oh, no. Before all that, I mean, OLD was starting, and it was Paddy Donnelly's father.
Yeah.
He wasn't 6 foot.
Yeah.
But he was always talking about the W formation, you know, two wingers, halfbacks, and the
half
back. And I always remember the first match, I don't know who we were. Oh, it was, there were senior people, like they were much older than us, like there was some Fox. I don't really know. I don't know half the people because they were much older than us, and we were playing them. It was our friendly match. It was actually behind the Father Tryon's place there, you know. There's no official pitch or anything. It just, I don't know if we had colts or what. But that was the start I remember at home LB as such. But Mr. Lennon was more interested in the football team, where OLB became a youth club.
Yeah.
And like there was Joe Jago, Mr. Kennedy, and his neighbour, I think he was his next door neighbour, and Jerry Farrell. No, don't know about that.
Jerry Farrell, Eamon Cotton, yeah, that's right. Jerry.
And his actual name was Michael Farrell. But seeing him, he was working in this place, there was two workers, so they called him Jerry. And he was the famous coach of Eamon Cotton. But he had us joined into Metropolitan Harriers as well, running and all that sort of thing. And Jerry was very interested in sports and that. So he started running some of the teams, OLB. So OLB was one of the, along with Bromley, was one of the first football teams in Ballyfermot. And I have a photograph at home somewhere, Joe Jago, Paddy Steppert, Bobby Steppert, the Donalds. You know the Donalds?
Yeah, I know of them.
Little Patson and Virginia.
There was twins, Paddy and John, Morris, Noel, Brendan. I think they all had, at one time.
I'm trying to figure out where that photograph is now. No, I have a good view of OLB. I'll look them up for you.
And there was Sean Royal, who lived on top of Landon Road. Who else? Sean Royal. Robbie King. He lived somewhere where he used to deliver. One of them, you know, that road that goes across Coilmore Avenue.
The crescent of the avenue to play in the drive and sleep.
But Robbie King, I don't know whether I know right, Robbie King wasn't fully grown. You know?
Yeah.
And the chap I mentioned there lived on top of Landon Road. Oh. He was 6'6". And all my dreams used to be going out to play our matches on some Mount Prospect on a Sunday. We had this team, a 6 foot, who wore the first fella ever I ever remember with contact lenses. And they must have been made of glass or
something.
And Robbie King was that white. It was the most mixed up team you ever came across. Oh, there's another man, I don't know, Paddy Dwyer.
And that was it, you would have been in the what we call the shoe house down at the painter's
shop. It was the shoe house.
That's where it started off.
And someone like was the dance.
Yeah.
You know, and Dave would come in and say,
leave room for the Holy Spirit. Yeah.
And then you go in and what they did was they sold you, well, I was there as well, selling bottles of them or orange, you know. So you got a bottle of orange, so it cost 10 pence or whatever. I don't know what the money was at the time.
Big money. Overcharged.
And that was 10 shillings and pence, I'm not sure. Same stuff. And when you handed back the bottle, you got a little bar of chocolate. I can't remember the crystal.
Yeah.
It was a crystal, it was called. So if you didn't hand back the bottle,
you didn't get the bar.
So it was a way of getting the bottle.
Back.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah.
And it was the drummer. He lived up near St. Mary's Club.
Oh, yeah.
He used to play the drums.
And you were did you mention you were in a band? Just to fill you in there, it was a coincidence happened here. Pat was looking for a chap through the photographs, and the chap happens to be the same man that's doing the video today, Sean Brennan. So you just met, so it's great to see that, you know.
It's amazing.
It was amazing the way that happened, And did you stay long with Bromley yourself then?
No, I kind of finished with Bromley. I was the young boy who couldn't get any place. There's only two teams in Inchicore, both from United and Richmond Rangers. And neither of whom required my services. But I started playing for the Telegraph Messers at under 18, and we had a Mickey Mouse team. We won two matches in the hall, but I just wanted to play football. But in the heat of the rain, because of my persistence, I ended up playing with St. Pat's. And I also played with Round Towers in Kendalkin and brought them back into senior football. And I also won a FAI Junior Cup medal with Valley and I from Ballyfermot. So I thought, to me, I've had a great career, but a fellow who couldn't get his place on the team. I mean, there were so many fellas better than I was, you know, who never seemed to do anything. But I reached my pinnacles up and down.
And then when you got married, did you marry a girl from Ballyfermot?
I did. The jewel in the crown. Julie Sweeney from Ballyfermot Crescent.
Oh, Ballyfermot.
And we moved over to Green Hills, and I'm there 48 years, and Pat's been our neighbour the same amount of time.
And did you know each other from Ballyfermot?
No, I didn't know him, no.
My wife was from Cremona Road. That's our brother there, and I'm 10 K.
And your wife's sportsman?
Newland.
Yeah. People will know her, you know.
Because our sister still lives on it.
Ah, see.
Berno, she lives on it. For the way. In actual fact, I think it's Sonny Fox's house that used to play for OLD.
My God.
You know, but he was a much older person than we were at the time, you know. Because we were all kids and they were all in the going to their 20s, like, you know.
And just a question there, I was wondering, do you come back much to Ballyfermot?
I look like I require my medication. I come back to Ballyfermot for my medication. I go to Maloney's chemist where I've gone. I got well looked after there as a young fella and all.
Crohn's?
Which?
Crohn's?
No, Maloney's.
Oh, yeah.
And it's changed hands and still great. Yeah. But I started going with Judy when we met at Margaret Sherman's wedding. That Sean Sherman, the TD, his sister. And Sean and poor old Margaret died a few years ago, they're very sad. But I believe Sean is living up in Roosty.
Oh, that's really.
And I just say, by any chance he looks in, send my best regards. I'm very happy man. He started they started a pigeon putt course over the California Hills, and they used to be seen going down below with a lawnmower to cut the grade.
My God, yes, it is. But there was a question, you know, I'd like to know. I know you're here since 1958, back and forth, and like yourself, you grew up here. What would you think was the best change that happened to Ballyfermot? What would you think, whether it be a finance company, whether it be the area itself, would you think there has been a good change to Ballyfermot?
There has been, to me, there's been a great change as regards many people have not got up, and the best of, I see the best of families getting rare here with people. Like I often feel, there's a few of the women should be made Minister for Finance. They've done so well with their kids. And education is the way out, I think, for most people. And the credit union was taking an awful lot of thanks for that, because, I mean, to me, it was great, because I remember living on Saturday morning, and there would be, well, the Jews themselves, well, I don't know where they're all, but the money lenders used to be around, collecting money and all, and it was a disaster, you know. Yeah. And that's why I said the credit union was a great institution to come on the scene.
I remember that starting in Jesus South School, the Ballyfermot
Credit Union,
and it progressed and progressed into the shopping centre.
That's right.
But I also remember another instance, just go back in time again, the bottom shops of Ballyfermot had a co-op.
That's right.
Yeah. And rear.
The communist shop.
And Father Tribe stood at the junction of Hogan Road and Decies Road, in the middle of the road, telling us all it was a mortal sin to go into that shop down there. And after that, because my father believed in the co-op because he worked in England, and in the co-op, every time you got a dividend, and the people in England would have their holidays with the dividend they accumulated from the co-op.
Well, I wrote about it a few years ago because you'd done an interview in RTE on it, and I must give you a copy. The people that was involved in the court, they've since died, I think. But what amazed me about that was that story must have been huge then, back then, because one of them lived, I think it was Offaly or some place like that, and he got back to his parents that he was involved in the co-op and communism.
Yeah.
And it broke family relations for many years, you know. So, and if you get from Ballyfermot to Longford or wherever the chapter from there, you know, it must have been a huge story, you know. The police had such influence, you know, on that.
Oh, it's terrible. Yeah.
But just when I asked you that question, I was asked that question too, and I didn't want to put words in your mouth, but I was said the same thing, the credit union, just want me to know. I think so. The credit union took people from the money lenders to the brown doors that we had. Do you remember the brown doors and windows the same colour? And painting up their own houses, and they took pride in their houses then, you know. Yeah, it has to be one of the
Sean Nolan now, who would have been the main man for years. Yeah. The very father Sean, one of the nice gentlemen. Unfortunately, he's no longer with us.
I think you leave it there, that'll keep it going. Yeah. But I'd like us back maybe if we're doing an open day next year. You might give us a few stories.
But I just want to say thank you, Ballyfermot, for this long road that I've come down here. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
As I say, Ballyfermot to me is a fantastic place. And I was very proud to be part of Ballyfermot.
I just want to say one thing about it. There was dances up in the Ritz, parish social on a Tuesday for a half a crown, a two-band session. But we used to go up there with Paddy Donnelly. But the trouble was, you never stood in front of him, because Paddy was a brilliant dancer and a fine-looking fella. And you could get killed in the rush if you were standing in front of him. The women were waiting to go for them.
But funny you say it, you mentioned something there about the dances and the slow sets. I was belonged to the Legion Mary, and we had a man, Nicky Brennan. He died actually earlier on in the year there. And Nicky was a great man here, one of the many great people in Ballyfermot, you know. But he used to bring us everywhere. As you said, we had them heavy, and we went off on hikes to places that we would have never seen. But it was the same. He introduced us to our first dances, and like that story, we'd all dive in and we'd just slow set. And we'd be walking around in the Holy Spirit and running along the middle.
Oh, well, we were very brave, and it was a lady's choice we all ran into the toilets.
Well, of course, the thing about it, like, all well, Vegas, the first place.
That's right.
Yeah. And that progressed us up to the Ritz, which was suddenly, I don't know, like, there was chaos.
The most came, he said, but I was too young, I used to watch his government.
Saturday night was a bit of a mess in
I remember Lewis Brannigan up there one day. I was going up to Aggie's shop, and Lewis Brannigan was starting out a few years up there. He was sitting with the torch on the head.
Which is Aggie's shop?
There was 345. It was the first tent, it was a gap. Haley's on the far side. It was on the first cluster of the shop. The last house in the first cluster.
You know the shop that was at the top of Kylemore Drive?
Reardon's.
Reardon's.
Well, Jerry Fairman has that shop on time.
Jerry Fairman, that's right. He had the shop in somewhere there. Yeah. I know Fottles owned the big house up the lane there. Now, there was rumours going around, I don't know whether it's local myths or what, about that there was a leper colony there where the lawns is now. Did you ever hear that? A leper colony.
Well, funny you say it, there was a leper colony. But I thought it was more down near the California Hills.
Now, it could have been, but someone, I remember telling that there, and someone was saying that the old graveyard that was up that lane, that there was lepers.
I never heard that one.
The leper comes behind that wall up there. I think Fotheringham's over the big house up there.
Right,
and then Farmer Corrigan came.
Yeah, that's right. But you say that now, I heard it was more down at the California Hills. It could be wrong. But there was also, even going back before that, there was, there was a barracks down there. An army barracks down there, you know, that was going into the war, that, you know. But I did hear there was something down that way.
No, just sorry, there was always kind of these talks about the leper colony up there, you know.
Yeah.
The thing about, when we got bikes eventually, And I used to work with a chap living around the Inchicore, Lynch's, around there at the Grange Cross there. I used to cycle up to him.
327.
And then we'd cycle across Lefferty Road, over the railway bridge, clean paper mills, across the Mace Road into that other road that's blocked off now, and out onto Wattenstown Avenue, down Cromwell's Ford, Kimmage Road West, Floods Tangier, up and into Churchill to work, because the bridge wasn't on Coilmore Road, was it?
That's, yeah. That came for something then. It's all kinship there for years. Years.
Cycle all around. Yeah. I'm over the bush.
I think there was, back then there was only, as far as I remember, there was really three. There was three exits out. One was at the Canadian Road, yeah, onto the Nice Road. One was down by the Farley onto the Chapel Lizard, and one down by the Canadian Road, because you couldn't get past the Fever Hospital. Cherry Archer at one time, you know, in a car.
No,
there was a kind of a barrier going into Parmouth.
There was one that went up around the back of Balgany or so. I don't know if Balgany.
There was a country lane, and you can see the three lines still there.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
But you went all the way up and you came to a T junction, and there was a shop there, and that shop
Bullets.
Is probably still there. And then you turned right. And brought you over to Esker and down.
Yeah, that was full of the shadow.
That's where we used to cycle as young.
They went across there, and you go to Leuven or go back over to Dalton. I think you went on past Jerry Archer.
But not by car.
Oh, you could. I'll tell you one of the places you used to go by was the Mount Street Boys, or Mount Street Farm, which was a bit, you know,
that's right.
Mount
that's right.
Had a farm in
that's right. Near St. Paul's. Yeah.
So the back road
was
the way into the farm. So when you cycle down there, let's say, you come to a T junction, which is that shop is still there.
Yeah. Good man, that was a good shop.
They went all across the country lane, Esker, Cemetery. And then you went down that as a vocation school at Lucan. There's some of them places are still there. Because there was Esker House, it was a big house. And I remember working it, and there was farm labourers. You know, talking about 1960 something. There was still farm labourers and what would you call housemaids and things like that. Yeah.
Domestics.
And when I went back later years, house is gone, it's called that area there, there's council, corporation estate is there, and all people at Decies Road built it.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a corporation estate, and it was isolated on its own for donkey's years before it was developed.
Yeah, yeah.
That area. Yeah. Right.
I think you leave it at that.
If you go there, I'll fill up.
Yeah, yeah. Just to say thanks very much to you, Pat. Thanks very much.
I'd love to see you again. Well done, Ken. I'd
love to see you. In a year's time, I must
some photographs, because I have photographs of some of the kids out of the Ballyfermot OLD.
Oh, I'd love that. Yeah.
I don't know. I can think of they lived on the what's the one on the face of the top shops in that way? Ramley's, isn't it? Ramley's Road.
In the which shops
of Jesus?
Did he deliver the post to you too, Tom?
He did.
Where did you live?
Highmore.
243. Quern is 241. Nolan's 239.